Hey everybody. I've decided to pick up NCAA basketball 10 again to just see how well I can do. I mostly picked NCAA basketball 10 just because A, I can get through games kind of quickly, and B, I really enjoy the production of it, like the whole presentation of it all. So it's mostly that, so that way I can avoid having to do like 15-minute long halves in College Hoops 2K8, which I'd absolutely enjoy. But I think I could only get like 2 games done a stream if I did something like that, so I figured, I figured I'd do something like this. It says Drake would be very low. And Northern Iowa would be low as well. It's kind of weird because I kind of want to pick either Drake or Northern Iowa, as opposed to just Iowa or Iowa State, mostly because, like, now Iowa State's like a prestigious team. And Iowa is not so much, as far as I remember. Actually, let me check that. Iowa men's basketball, they're doing good. They're doing 12-5. That's quite good. And then, like, Iowa State is, like, a possibility of getting into the Final Four this year. Like, they're 12-3 right now. So, that's a little bit worse than they've been doing. But, like, it's 12-3. I believe they're a ranked team as well, if I remember right. I kind of want to check that real quick, just to kind of see how well it... Just to see where the top 25 is at. Because I'm pretty sure Iowa State's a top 25 team right now. Yeah, they're number 11. And I was not really there right now, but they're doing good. I believe Drake is doing quite pitiful right now. Yeah, they're 3-14 right now, but in this game, back in 2009, they were doing very well. And Northern Iowa, Northern Iowa did all right in this in 2009, and they're doing quite well this year as well. I mean, then again, they're beating a lot of kind of no-name teams. And then, of course, UNI is also, I guess, best known a few years ago for their, I think it was second round win against the, number one Kansas at the time. So, it's kind of hard to pick a team right now. Like I said, I could do Drake, but they're considered a top 25 team, like, in this game already. Did they just do the cell phone thing already? Yeah, I did. Like, okay, Iowa State's team isn't great, but, you know, I could do Iowa. You know, I'm still kind of trying to decide right now. I'm thinking Northern Iowa, because they're doing all right now, and they aren't great in this game, so I wonder if I can turn them around the same time that, they were turning around in real life. So, I don't really have an Iowa basketball team that I could turn around, per se. I mean, like, Iowa State, I guess, but... like, they're a legit contender for the NCAA championship. I could do Iowa. Because I think they fare even worse than Iowa State right now. But I want to do something other than just the normal Iowa teams, because, like, just the two big teams, because of the fact that they have the Missouri Valley Conference on here, I can do some of the lesser known Iowa teams. And since Drake is considered a top 25 team in this game, I may end up picking Northern Iowa and working with them. So, I don't know why they assume I just want to do 15. We'll do 30 years. I don't know how long this will work. I don't know how popular this will get, but we'll test it out. Simulation. Oh, Jesus. Okay, this thing's just hitting buttons for me now. Injury frequency normal. Underclassmen go pro. Low player transfers. Schedule customization. Everything seems pretty peachy there. All the rules there. Let's just stick to varsity for right now, just to see how well it goes. We'll do auto subs, since I'm not a big sub guy. I don't know my whole team right this second, so. Broadcast, you know, we may end up, we'll probably end up changing that, just because I enjoy kind of a 2K look to it. So, I'll probably shy away from the broadcast stuff. And I'll figure out the camera when I actually get to that. So let's see. We're a B-minus overall right now. Which is pretty good. Let's see. Drake is also a B-minus, which is kind of weird for a 28-5 team. But, you know, this must have been kind of when they're when they started going south. Let me take a look at Iowa. Iowa State a C+. That probably would have been a possible team. But once again, they're like a contender now, so. And I'm already doing Iowa State for football. And a B- for Iowa, so. Doing pretty good for that. Let's see. We need center and a small forward. We got 5 scholarships to do that. We're also going to need a power forward, because we got a senior who's going to be heading out after a little while. Let me look. Is that who we really got as a... Maybe we don't really have a good small forward, do we? But we got plenty of point guards. Jesus Christ. Okay, let's do something about this. We can redshirt him. We can redshirt him. And now we'll be down to just 4 point guards. Holy crap. Is that how many we got? 1, 2, 3, 4. Alright. We only got 2 shooting guards. We got... Yeah. We'll just stick to that. We got 13 people on the court. That'll be good enough. Schedule. This is usually the fun one. Start removing some of these. I don't know where that tournament is. I may have just accidentally gotten rid of that. We're just gonna get rid of some of these games and figure out who we're gonna put in here. Let me see. First off, we should probably put some of the Iowa teams in here. Just so we can have our usual... There we go. Maybe avoid Drake for right now. Ooh. You can start throwing in some good teams here. Oh, we got Drake in our conference, so we're already gonna deal with them. Let's see. Ooh. UCLA, that's crushing you won't help us, thanks. That's alright. We'll figure out something. Florida? No. So it looks like we're gonna have to work our way into some better games. There we go. We'll do at Ole Miss. Why not? That'll help. Oh, there's the tournament. Okay. Miami, Southern Utah, UC Riverside. You don't want a bunch of stupid easy games. Yeah, we should probably do Gonzaga. Nope. All right, well, they'll play us if we go there. Dayton, I'm trying to see some of the teams that we could play. ACC's usually got some good teams we can play. Maybe not top 25 teams. Like, oh, Wake Forest. We might need to add in some... There we go. Yeah, we'll add in some teams that... some teams that... You know, perhaps have some name value to them, but are also... not maybe a top 25 team, so we can actually get some home games against some of these teams. Because I feel that could be a little bit of a problem as we go along here. Holy crap, is there not a good Big Ten team to play? Kansas State, Missouri, Nebraska, Texas Tech, they're usually... Okay. Texas A&M. Nebraska. Alright, Nebraska. Why not? And we can add one more. And I'm going to make some of the easier games towards the end after this whole stretch. So... Auburn, Florida, Georgia? Alright, Georgia. And then we'll keep Eastern Illinois and Cleveland State. And then that'll take us into the... Yeah. So that'll work. Preseason training. Let's do 35... 25... 20... And 20... Yeah. We'll want some... We want some shooting drills for them. Recruiting Central. This one is also phenomenally easier to recruit people. In comparison to, say, College Hoops. So, trying to see. Alright, target him. Target the three-star guys first that might want to be a part of this. Alright. So we got a few. Now let's target some of the... Oop. Missed one. So, I think we're also going to need maybe another small forward. Just trying to see somebody who's got some good rank to them. He looks pretty good. I think we got... Do we need a center still? I think I'll do another center as well, just to be safe. There we go. Ooh, that might be a better guy. 7 feet. Where is this other center? Is he the one? Yeah, we'll take him out. We don't want no 6'8 center anyway. That'd just be ridiculous. Alright. I don't like that they're going to have some additional recruits for me because I have the guys I want. But that's all right. Let them go through their training camp. Legit, what? Hang on. Ah. There we go. Recruiting Central. Now we can go back to... Alright, this was the short list. I don't remember all the guys that I... Alright, we'll take the ones that are very low and we'll get rid of them because I don't see us getting them. I don't want to waste my time on them. I don't want to waste my time on people we're almost certain not to get. There we go. Sorry, just gotta get through this. Undo everything the freaking computer did. Why do you think I'm gonna get, like, a top 100 guy my first year in? I don't know why they assume that. Like, when people like UCLA is trying to get him. Like, why would he come to Northern Iowa? Alright, that's a lot of centers that you're asking of me. And I got rid of that guy, too. God damn it. But they brought him back, because it's like, eh. You know you want him. No, I don't. Let's see. These will be the two that I target. These two can go away. Because I do not need them. There. And those are my six guys. I hope to God they do not mess with that. Let's watch the game. And send a letter of interest. Actually, yeah, we'll watch his game. Think we're gonna need someone like him. So send a letter of interest, watch his game. As far as the shooting guard goes, let's do him. Well, yeah. Send a letter of interest, watch his game. And then for the other ones, send a letter of interest, internet research. Don't want to waste too many points on these guys. Send a letter of interest, internet research. So I got enough to pitch for the other guys. Man, I do not have a lot of recruiting points to do this with. Alright. Let me see here. Let me save this real quick. Just to be safe. Alright. I believe that takes us to actual, well, I kind of already redshirted all my players, so that just takes us to our first game. Sweet. I hardly ever answer the phone when it does that crap. I just don't care. There we go. Hey, that's a good start. Might not even have to join in this game. Looks like we got this one well in hand already. A very good start to the season, if I must say so myself. 80-65 win over Iowa State. We'll sim up to here because I think that'll give me the 1 week. Alright. Check my recruiting for that. Alright, for these guys, let's see, who were the guys I wanted? I think this is the guy that I want more, because he's the 3-star. So let's have the head coach visit, tell him about his playing time. Assistant coach can do a phone call. Well, let's see, how much would something like that? Yeah, I got some wiggle room here. Tell them the strategy. And then... for him, we'll do basically the same thing. We probably don't got to do a whole lot. Which is good, because we don't have a lot of points. Assistant coach phone call on... strategy. Oh, I think while we're at it, we'll also offer a scholarship. Since that doesn't cost any money. We'll offer a scholarship to him as well. And one to him as well. Did I do much of anything with him? No. Let's do head coach phone call with him. I'll see about giving him a scholarship. Let's see, for him, we'll do an assistant coach visit on his playing time. Ah! I forgot to offer him a scholarship. Head coach phone call on, we'll do strategy, and then offering him scholarship. All right. And then with the head coach phone call, we'll offer a scholarship for him as well. We only got 5 scholarships. Maybe one of these people will not sign with me. He probably will. That's the guy I really want, so he hopefully will. We should hopefully get some good players coming in next year. We'll see how well that works out. That takes us. Oh, hey! People are showing up now. Nice. Jesus, 4 people just showed up all at once. It went from 0 to 4, just like that. How you guys doing? Try to send your stream over. Oh, I didn't even realize you were streaming. I would have gone and watched that. I've been busy all day freaking downloading anime. I would have just watched your stream while continue downloading my anime. Oh boy. I'm going to have to probably step into this one. Yeah. We can give it a shot. It's probably going to be one of those where I'm going to get my ass kicked, but eh. Oh shit, did I already back out of the whole game? Well, you know what? I'll take that as a opportunity to change up some things. Team style selection. We're an up-tempo team. What series did I grab? Let's see. Through some of the websites that I found, I downloaded all basically the ones that I've been watching, that or I have watched. So all of Oreimo, all of Watamote, all of Lucky Star, and I'm now like 2/3 of the way through SAO. And then I'll be working on probably a couple of the other ones that I watch as well. So just a crap load of them. roster management. Trying to see. I think if I already do the up-tempo, that should be fine. Lucky Star, I don't know why. It's one of those things that I'm just like, I was addicted to that show. It was really weird. It's like, it seems like the kind of show I wouldn't like, but I freaking loved it. Coaching, report card, breakdown. I think I'm good. Alright, let's just go back to the calendar. Oh, hey, look, I get another shot at hopefully not being down by 28 points if I have to take over. Yeah, that is a little bit better. That's probably where I should do it. Otaku Seinfeld. It really is. It's a show about next to nothing. There's not a whole lot that goes on. It's Seinfeld, but with, like, 17-year-old anime girls. Especially that first episode. I got so freaking close in those first, like, 6 minutes. Because it's like, they are literally just talking about food. Like, I was a little like, I don't know if I want to watch this. But I'm glad I stuck with it. I actually just finished the series, like, last night. It was like the last 3 episodes or so I hadn't actually gotten to for a while. Oh. Just an FYI, I don't know if you can hear this. If you hear some weird background buzzing noise, it's just my Xbox desperately trying to keep up with the disc, because for some reason this is the one game that my Xbox has trouble with just keeping up with. I don't know why. Maybe I can get my mic down here to. So yeah, it's weird buzzing. So if you hear weird buzzing, that's what it is. Whoops. Okay. Okay. First off, let's change the camera. Overhead, let's bring it down a little bit. Right about there. Is that probably about the best I'm going to get? Yeah. It's about the closest I'm going to get to like a 2K deal. Okay. Is there something I can look at for the controls? Because Jesus Christ, do I forget how to... Yeah, okay. I just gotta check this out real quick. I've been so used to playing 2K, I just have to remember how to play this. Move fast, shoot, standing dunk, pick and roll. Alley-oop, direct pass switch, okay. Alright, turbo size, alley-oop, direct pass switch, okay. That's what that one did. Quick strike, dribble moves, back down. Okay, that's what backing down is. Freestyle pass. I think the rest I can figure out.
Tries to get around the trap, but he can't do it.
Well done.
Uh-oh. He ain't gonna make. Ooh, he did make that. Oh.
He can put points up, and he can move the ball.
I'm so used to, like, intense D, so I'm like, it's just in my nature to try to hit the left trigger.
That spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby.
Ah, damn it. Yeah, Dick Vitale in commentary, so that'll be fun. Oh, oh, oh. Oh, damn it.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Nance picks up the foul. First team foul. Let's take a second look at this three.
I forgot about Dick Vitale on commentary.
For two. Off the glass.
Here we go.
Pushes it.
Who are my shooters? You're my shooter.
Shoots from outside.
All right, so I know who to hand the ball off to. If I need a good shot, my point guard will take care of the threes.
Inside. Goes up for two.
Wow, really? I'm going to try to pound Ole Miss into the ground.
For the deuce.
Really? But he can't make that? Jesus Christ.
Try to pack it inside for two. Goes in.
This fucking game. Oh my God.
Now in transition.
All right.
Had a shot block. Fast break opportunity here.
Wow. Forgot how to play this damn game. All right.
Oh, it looked like he had an easy basket coming up, but the defense commits a foul instead.
Great play there, Brad. He was able to foul him in order to prevent the easy basket.
And here's what it looks like if you average out his numbers over the course of the season.
One thing that stats don't show, Brad, are the intangibles. The pass that leads to the pass that ultimately leads to a score. Deflections, diving for loose balls.
Jesus. My team can't rebound very well, I guess. What the fuck was that? I gotta remember how to play this damn game. This is ridiculousness. The most ridiculous thing here is I used to be good enough at this game that if I was down by like 15 points with like 3 minutes left, it'd be like, yeah, that ain't no fucking big deal.
That spin move not successful, Dick.
I did a great job on the defense not allowing him to make that turn.
Yeah, I'll just give it to my point guard. He can shoot three. Of course he doesn't make it. Like I said, I used to be able to come back from literally anything. Because of shit like that. Whoops. But then you get bullshit like that, where it's like... The guy...
On the left side.
Try and get everyone to touch. We did. We absolutely did. Nobody gets open.
Goes up for two. That is a dagger in
my
the
answer to raise. Hi, David.
Time out to regroup, Brad. Try to go inside.
And they do. They got it on the low block.
There.
Was that beautiful or
we got at least that much.
As we continue to track the
game. Hey, I got a Wiggins on my team.
Fourth action is definitely the reason why we are getting that reading, Brad.
On the dribble, gives it up. Jumper.
Man, they're making some of the stupidest shit. I'm starting to remember why I don't play this game.
They'll work it around the arc.
Come on.
From the top of the circle.
There we go. That was a two? being so enthusiastic to your favorite viewer.
He just can't escape the pressure.
The man can't get past it, Brad.
On the outside, from the corner.
Ah, oh, God damn it.
Three-point range. On the wing.
There you go. I just got to play like a shithead in this game. That's how you got to do it. You just don't do strategy. I forgot. This is an EA basketball game. Does not involve actual legit strategy. It just involves finding a shot that perhaps maybe you could make and then just going at it. And spamming the steal button. That's how that works as well. Because you're either going to get a foul or you're going to get an actual steal. Or you're going to turn the ball over like that for them.
On the left side, with the jumper, and come up short.
Yep, see? Spam the steal button. Who cares? Oh, and spam three-point shots if you got three-point shooters.
He's taking too many unnecessary shots.
Momentum can swing in your favor.
Wow.
You enough to blow your game.
It's all right. I'll take it.
I like it when the team gets to the free throw line. It shows that they're being aggressive. The key is to get to the line early in the game and often.
Got a boat.
Oh, he drained it.
I forgot. Every school in every...
1 minute left on the game clock.
Every school, every arena. Oh, what the fuck is that shit? They gotta go, whoo, after every... Come on. Come on. Come on. Turn that ball over for me. It's either gonna be a foul or a turnover.
For the bucket. Off target.
All right.
The three... No.
Oh, come on.
Kicks it out.
Like I said, this doesn't involve much strategy. You just got to play like a dickhead in this game.
Now, looking to attack. Well, that was just coast to coast.
I got to play more like a dickhead in the next game. Whoop. Shit. Go get him. Go get him. Go get him.
Set in.
Come on.
That's a foul. The baseline inbounds.
They can make it.
There we go.
Interesting with a score here.
Now on the run. He attempts the three. He misses the jumper.
Yeah.
He finished it with a
damn. Where the hell is a pink Pepsi, by the way?
Northern Iowa loses a close one.
It's tough to lose such a
33
game,
points, 38 points.
With the effort they put for.
That's going to do it for us, folks. Thanks for being along. For Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews.
Goddamn last dude's last name is Ashley, by the way. The leader of our team. Japan? Eh, I should have known. Oh, well, that was a close game, and we're not a fantastic team. It's really weird, because I think this game literally came out like the year before they... Either a year or two before they did their big Kansas game in the tournament and knocked out Kansas. There we go. This might be a little bit easier game if I have to jump in. This is a close one. Will I have to jump in? Yeah, I'm going to jump in right there. White Boy Land basketball court. Have you been to Iowa? Especially Northern Iowa. We don't get... Northern Iowa is king of just the fucking short white boys. I I'd say it's a decent game. Like, NCAA basketball is decent. If you want, like, a really good college basketball game, College Hoops 2K8 is absolutely the one. The only reason I'm playing this over that is that I can do the simulcast or the hoopcast and go through games a lot quicker, because College Hoops doesn't have that, so I'd have to legit play like 16 minute halves if I wanted to replicate some of the scores. Because I like to at least try to replicate, like, scores that happen in college basketball. Oh my god! Why was that an issue?
So Dick's so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up and the other four will go to
just jack up shots. There you go. Come on. Come on.
Number 15 takes the feed.
I won't spam it, but I'll definitely get in there. Yeah, the reason I'm downloading all this anime is, number one, I could put it on a hard drive if I wanted to, but the big reason is I'm planning on actually using my Blu-ray player and or Blu-ray burner on my computer that I've had, and I've not burned a single Blu-ray since I've had it. So I'm planning on actually creating Blu-rays, and I figured, why not just do it of shows that I watch? Come on, jack that ball from him.
Daniel picks up the foul. First team foul.
The whitest dude ever with the name of Jamal.
They'll throw this one in from the side.
I don't need adult films. I already got Arimo.
He takes a three.
Ah, god damn it.
No good.
White Jamal.
Well, if there is such a thing as a good foul, that was probably it.
Sure was, Brad.
Not to mention there's a dude with the last name of Ashley.
Here's another solid junior, Dick.
You can never have enough leadership on your roster.
And of course I've got the forgotten Wiggins brother on here. The white Wiggins brother. Kind of like the Black Hall, like the black sheep of the family, so to speak.
They might have him in some trouble here, Dick.
Great trap, Brad.
Now they work it around the perimeter. About 4 minutes remaining. Lobs.
Whoops.
It. They'd like to get it inside to the low block.
There we go.
Executes the baby hook.
I tell you, the jump hook's so effective, especially against a big post player. Very difficult to block that shot.
For the bucket.
There we go.
No
good. There he is.
He shoots from the corner. He might be on his way to a career game, partner.
All right, I guess my guy's having a... One of my guards is having a fantastic game right now.
For two. Two with a lay-in.
Damn it. I forgot this is also an EA Sports game, so no one really looks human. Thanks, asshole, for standing out in the fucking out of bounds.
The Hawkeyes have been making it happen with a number of different players, Dick.
It's been great to watch them move the ball like that, and they're doing all the things it takes to win.
Jesus.
They're committed to playing good team defense, and when your team is doing those type of things, you're smiling as a coach.
Goes up for two. What do you think, Dick?
They need a timeout here, Brad.
All right. On the game clock. On the dribble, gives it up. Tries for two.
What was it, the fancy shit? You were right there for a dunk, you dumbass. You bumbling fucking retard. Come on, double team him. Told me I gotta press and hold, double team him. This is how we're gonna do this. We're just gonna double team these guys. Oh, are you kidding me with that stupid shit?
Got it.
Sorry, I'm just a little irritated at some of this shit.
Cross court. For the bucket. Scorches the
damn it. There you go. Just freaking plow that thing down.
2 minutes left on the game clock. The crowd starting to chant.
There you go. Such thing as a home court advantage. Don't you dare start that warm up the bus chant. I will fucking murder you.
He fouled him. Well, it commits an intentional foul there.
Ugh, fuck you guys, you know, warm ass weather.
Smart play, Brad, especially if you can afford
warm up for what?
I like his mentality. No easy basket.
Makes it.
While he's doing that, 19, all right.
Second shot is no good. Daniel receives the pass. He unloads a three.
There you go. Oh, come on. What is with people not crashing the boards?
Parks handles the pass.
Just spam the freaking steal button. Looking Wait for him to shot. Get that damn thing. Now there's the warm up the bus. Wow, are you shitting me? Yeah, I said 19. That's about where I'm at.
It's almost an expectation, Brad. You're supposed to win your home games, but winning by this amount, my goodness.
We are not dead yet.
Traps in place, Dick. Count that as a personal foul. Mosley comes back into the game.
Oh, wait, no. Now we are. They took all our freaking starters out, it looks like.
Just like you, Mr. Nestler.
One minute left on the game clock. The Panthers
really
to have him pick up too many more fouls.
Wilson should be fired. Fuck off. Oh my God.
The offense sets up from the sideline.
Pressure that basketball.
There we go.
The ball stripped. It's a fast break possibility. Kicks it out.
Shut up with your warm up the bus. We still got a shot. It's a slim one, but we still got a shot. Oh my God. Oh, how do they still make shit like that? There we go. Just drive it in. Fuck it.
Man might be in a little bit of trouble here, Dick. The Hawkeyes are in the bonus. Let's take another look at this dunk.
He took this one strong and hard, Mr. Nestler. That,
damn it.
Makes a coach proud.
And there's a look at the young freshman.
Hey, Brad, first-year player starting his college career.
And, of course, they were worse off after I started playing. God damn. Maybe I should just stick to football and wrestling.
That line is really being good to him tonight, Dick.
That line's always good, Brad. These guys just have to make good use of it.
He makes the jumper. Beasley comes up with it. They're off into transition.
We're not dead yet. We're done, but yeah.
Chance to get an easy one here. Hits that one. Dick, they're really getting it done from the line.
God damn it.
And a surprisingly collective effort, Brad.
With the big shot. Was that beautiful or what?
Like it fucking mattered. God damn. Ugh, that stuttering.
While we've got a moment here, Dick, let's take a look at our players of the
game. Oh my God, is that the Incredible Hulk?
Both stepped up for their teams and made this game interesting.
I'm telling you, they don't fucking look... The EA Sports, they never look human.
This is going to be hard to swallow since they were the favorites coming into this game.
Brad Nessler saying so long for my partners, Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews. Thanks for joining us.
Damn. Huh. Railgun looks interesting. Technically, I know there was a joke. It's like, eh, it looked like they were trying to make a wrestling game, but they ended up with basketball. Yeah, it's because the last time they made a wrestling game, they made WCW Backstage Assault. Oh, Desert Punk should totally be the next thing I download, by the way. That should absolutely be... That should absolutely be the next one. WCW Mayhem. Well, Backstage Assault came after Mayhem. Immortals is pretty fun. It's a lot like Injustice, but very simplistic. Like, there's really only a couple of combos to learn, and then like the special, moves. And, like, there's a way to... Because it's, like, you tap the button to do, like, the regular strikes. And then, like, you swipe quickly to do the bigger strikes. And then there's, like, a 1, 2, and 3 to do, like, the 1, 2, and 3 level, like, moves and stuff. And you can give them, like, little bitty bonuses and stuff like that. But, yeah. It'd be nice if they did something like that. It's a very, very simplified Injustice, basically. And it's 3-on-3. You do three... It's 3 players apiece. Wow, we already actually got a guy signed. Nice. Oh, shit, they all fucking signed. Oh, except the one fucking dude I wanted. Shit. They all fucking signed already. God damn it. I knew I shouldn't have given it to that one dude. Ugh. I am so sorry. God damn it. Wasn't Railgun the anime that you got the t-shirt from Redbubble from? I wasn't sure. I thought it was like a Railgun something. On the bright side, I don't have to worry at all anymore recruiting. I'm done with recruiting. I've gotten all five of my scholarships are done already. Come on. This is one we need to win. Tyler needs a win. Cool. That was one I needed. As soon as I get some extra money, which should be as soon as my money goes into my bank account, I'm absolutely planning on getting a Watamote shirt and then something else. I don't know. There was a couple of wrestling posters that looked really sweet. Like, it was like wrestling, but like comic book style. Like a comic book style Shield poster. Look pretty sweet. All right, Ashley. This is the best ones when I don't really have to step in and my team can actually do the work for me. I have not watched Welcome to NHK yet. You know what? I may very well just download it since I've been on a downloading spree. Damn. Come on. Just wipe the floor with Old Dominion. Ah, shit. Come on. Come on. Come on. Fucking keep it up. Alright. I'm gonna join in at 66 all. Probably not the greatest idea. I'm gonna say this is probably a stupid idea, but oh well. I love how she is very purposely, like, pushing up her boobs with that. Oh, I'll look into it. Ah. Don't be doing A's in my chat. What the fuck? Am I playing in like a fucking high school gym or some shit?
And our trifecta for the night. Aaron Andrews on the sideline. I'm Dick Vitale. I'm Brad Nessler. Nice to have you along with us. Out on the right wing. Work it inside, and he tries a drop step. Defensively, nice job.
Great job. Well, don't you dare tell me that was a fucking... Alright, what the fuck happened to the... Yeah, overhead. They always gotta be so screwy with the cameras. Oh, there you go.
Comes up with it. Now looking to move it down court in a hurry.
Wow, no foul.
The shooting guard gets the pass.
Up and inside.
Aha, spamming the steal button.
He shoots from the deep corner.
Oh my god. Why is this a thing?
Looking for a good shot. Beasley picks up the foul.
You see the card for takeover yet? I have not. I didn't realize there was another takeover already.
Too ice cold out there sitting on that pine. Sometimes you get to be a little frigid.
They move it into the front court. They work the perimeter.
Oh my god, will someone get the fucking ball away from him? Fucking really? Oh my god, my team fucking blows at that shit.
Congratulations to our...
Fuck a fucking duck. Holy shit, was that fucking... Oh, I can't wait till I can... Holy shit. Duke Downs, previously undefeated Ohio, 105-44. Look at that. Duke Downs, previously undefeated Ohio, 105-44. Holy shit. I can't remember if I found some new anime that I might watch. I'm not sure yet. Oh god, I keep getting messages on Meet Me. Why those under... They were probably facing a lot of, like, bullshit teams, is probably what it was. I'll have to... Oh, you know what? I don't have Welcome to NHK in my, consider watching. Welcome to NHK... Oh yeah, I'll figure out. You know, if you want to tell me the card, feel free. That's up to you. Oh, one of my work buddies wanted me to watch Noeen. N-O-E-I-N. He told me that would probably be something that's up my alley. And another one I found was Golden Time. That one looked kind of cool too. Noeen, Golden Time, and Parasite all looked like interesting ones. The thing that really got me into gold, made me consider Golden Time, was they have an abridged one-shot that someone made, and it's fucking phenomenal. Okay. Oh, shit. Just like that, it's already over, and we won. Golden Time on my watch. Super drama romance. Okay, because it looked a bit more comedic, but okay. You know, I'm not big on... I'll take light romance, but, like, I'm more a comedy person at this point. Like, I think slice of life comedies tend to be my wheelhouse. I didn't even, like, I think I mentioned that before, that, like, I accidentally found basically what I, what I'm into is, like, slice of life comedies. With the occasional, like, oddball, like, with the occasional ones that's a little bit outside of that, like, you know, the supernatural stuff, like Dokuro-chan and... you know, SAO. Shit. Do I get a chance? I may join. This is Gonzaga, so I'm going to take a chance. Kayon. I've heard Kayon. Yeah, I've heard Kayon's pretty good. Tend to watch anime that hits me. I tend to not do that, and I don't know why. Like, I've got my fill of anime that hits me in the feels with some of the other shit, like SAO and all that shit, where it's like, okay. You know, they got their little moments. I enjoy ones like that. It's all like Lucky Star minus Hot Taco things. Well, that'd be kind of, that's probably pretty good then. I'd be into that.
Joining us tonight with Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler.
Boom. Daniel is known as one of those passers. I'm not saying I might not watch certain things, but you know, I got certain things I that appeal to me just because they're more lighthearted. Jeez, not a charging foul or anything?
He lets it go. He misses the jumper.
Let's see if he can't drive in. Nope.
Kicks it out. He shoots from the deep corner.
Ah, damn it.
He misses the J.
I saw something that was actually kind of funny. That, I think it's mostly funny because I haven't seen it in a few years. And that was the Hitler Reacts videos. You know, where they take that same, where they have that one World War II movie with the one Hitler scene where he's like freaking out on people, and you know, it's like Hitler reacts to whatever, and it was one where it was like the Oreimo ending.
The small forward gets the ball.
I thought it was kind of funny. Where it's just like, what the fuck kind of joke is this shit? Like, I thought Oreimo was just supposed to be like a brother and sister getting a better relationship. Like, I actually got kind of a kick out of it, probably because I haven't watched any of those Hitler React videos in a while. Oh shit, let's see if I remember how to do this. Okay. He's like, they had such a great thing going with Kiyosuke and Kuroniko, and then you spin that shit into Kirino? Like, she was a complete bitch to him. What the fuck?
About a minute remaining in the game clock. Off the glass and no good.
Oh my god.
With a layup. 3 points is the difference.
That's right. He's like, someone find the author. We're gonna make this right. He's like, the original ending isn't canon, but sir, they have the PSP game. We're gonna find the author. And he's going to change it. And if he refuses, we're going to make the Kuroniko route on the PSP game canon.
On the right side, the crowd is definitely doing.
Oh my god, really?
Who says there's no such thing as a home court advantage?
All right, see if we can't just put up a fucking random ass shot. Come on. All right, spam that fucking steal button. Come on.
Sets up from the sideline. And we got a whistle and a foul. They'll throw this one.
Oh my god.
Count that as a personal foul.
Are we in the bonus yet so we could just send him to the line or at least try to get rid of the goddamn. Come on, motherfuckers. Give us a foul or a fucking steal. Oh, what a fucking hunk of shit this game is. Jesus fucking Christ. Like, I'm not pissed, I guess, but that's fucking disappointing. Feel free to watch Dragon Gate. It'll probably be much better than this shit. Me just yelling at my goddamn... just yelling at my goddamn Xbox. Oh my god. What a sack of shit that game was. At least the ending. Holy fuck. Just sitting there, like, swiping the ball. It's like, either fucking foul him, or take the ball away. Don't just swipe 18,000 times and then nothing happens. Like, fuck. I swear to God, I'm not this angry usually. It's just, fuck me. Broadcast PT. Sorry, I don't understand. I get it, basketball makes you angry. You know what? It's not even like all games. It's like EA Sports horseshit games. Playable teaser. It's a free demo for PS4. Might have to check that out. Fun game I heard, yeah. Everything also downloads like ass on my PS4. I think they throttle the freaking... Oh my god. Yeah, there's no way I'm coming back from that. That's a beating. On the bright side, I'm gonna get through this season pretty freaking quick. Alright. Now this should be much better. Because now I'm facing some no-name teams. I should be able to just sort of have some solid games. Come on, what are you gonna do? What are you gonna do? Oh boy. Should I take a chance? I'm gonna take a chance. I'm gonna fuck this up for my team, I just know it. Gonna fuck this all up. Can't wait. I'm already preparing myself for the inevitable screaming match I'm gonna have with my Xbox. Like, you motherfucker! On the bright side, I always love the presentation in this game. It's always amazing.
Well, thank you for joining us tonight with Dick Vitale.
Oh, come on! Number one, I forgot that the right bumper did that goddamn thing. Come on! Come on! Fucking get that ball away from them! Oh my god! Either foul them or fucking steal it! Oh my god. What a dog shit game that actually worked out in my advantage. This fucking horseshit game worked out so well in my advantage. Oh my god. I fucking won due to some fucking horseshit programming. You've got to be able to execute, and coming out of a timeout, I think it's really important, don't you, Dick? You know, it's mandatory, Brad. Oh my god. All five players on the same page and ready. Oh, Jesus. Because they fucking program the guy to not figure out where the out-of-bounds line is, I get the ball back in some horseshit way. Because my guys won't intentionally foul for some odd reason. Oh my god. That's amazing. That's just amazing. On the bright side, because I've been downloading all this HD anime, I've been going back and just like watching some of the other shows. It's like, oh, let's see, I download this. What was happening on this episode of SAO? What was happening on this episode of Oreimo? Maybe appreciate some of those later season 2 episodes. before the official like OVAs on Arimo as well. Like the mini battle that like Ayase and Kuroniko had was just phenomenal. Where it's like, you're here, what the hell are you doing here? Why are you here before evening? Well, I'd be too busy in the afternoon. But you're here just to show off your uniform. Well, what are you? Like, it's just not making Blaine a mod. Well, I mean, I didn't not make him a mod on purpose. It's just he's not enough of a regular that I've seen him around to make him a mod. Oh god, come on. Okay, I gotta take a chance. Fuck. I'm gonna fuck this up, I guarantee it. I'm gonna do it all over again. Maybe some horseshit will lead to me winning. He sacrifices life codes to... Yeah, and that's cool. Not the sacrificing goats thing, but the fact that this is really one of the only times you've really ever watched. Oh, that's cool. If I start getting my ass kicked in some stupid ways, I may just switch to NBA 2K15 at this point. Because that game actually involves some strategy.
Well, thank you for joining us tonight with Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews. I'm Brad Nessler.
Look, I'm just going to barrel all the way down the court with this dude and just slam it home. Oh, there you go.
It's all about quick hitters and pressing. The good thing is that this team is capable of putting up points in a hurry.
On the dribble, gives it up. Ashley picks up the foul. First personal foul.
Fallen since 2K15 came out. Oh, cool. The one thing I don't like is you can't intercept inbounds passes in this game for some reason, which is how I've beaten better teams in college hoops, was by doing that shit. By the way, my team does not know how to crash the glass.
Well, he commits an intentional foul there to prevent the easy basket.
That's a smart play, Brad, especially if you can afford to use a personal foul. I like the mentality. No easy basket.
Steps to the line for an easy one. First shot is good.
God damn. Ooh. Ooh, everyone gets their arms up. Ah. Ooh. Ready? 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 Ooh.
Gets the second shot. Davis makes his way back in.
God damn it.
You think it's a good move, Dick?
Yeah, it's a
move. God damn it, by the way. Just there. Fucking slam that shit home. Or just do that. That. Oh my god, we couldn't even get the rebound on the block. You son of a bitch.
And now there's a whistle and a foul. The Panthers go to the line for the first time in this game. Gets the first shot.
Da-da-da-da. Well, there's an interesting... That looks like the slightly more adult Lucky Star for some reason.
Gets them both to fall. The lead trickles down to four.
Time is either your best friend or your worst enemy at this point, Brad.
He misses.
There we go.
1 minute left on the game clock. On the left side. He attempts the trifecta.
Oh, really? You can't make the fucking open ones? Run. Fucking foul his ass. Am I picking my wife?
And they continue to fight to stop the clock. They'll set it up from the baseline.
Oh, what was another one that looked kind of funny? Honey and Clover. I don't know if I'd mentioned that. Honey and Clover looked good as well. Looked interesting at the very least. Mostly because it looked like there is like an anime version of Van Wilder. If he fucking made that shit, I'd be pissed. Oh my god, he still fucking made that. God damn.
The power forward takes the pass.
You need to create as many possessions as possible, so keep fouling.
Just get the foul.
And they continue to foul to stop the clock. Foul, and that stops the clock again.
Are we in the bonus yet? Or are they in the bonus? There you go.
Coaches love it when their team gets to the free throw line.
Hey, everybody get your arms up. Get your arms up. Here we go. Here we go.
Second shot, good. On the outside. He shoots from the corner.
Boom.
And the clock stopped with a foul.
I've heard about Idol Master. Like, I've heard about something called Idol Master. I don't know about Cinderella Girls. Like, is it just that? Is that the full name? Like, Idol Master Cinderella Girls? Just kind of wondering about that. Oh, shit. Wrong button.
And they continue to foul to stop the clock.
Okay.
Chance to get an easy one here.
Jesus. Yeah, this is the perfect time for them to be hitting everything. Oh, there we go.
Rims off. Ashley handles the pass. He shoots from the deep.
Oh my god. Please, for the love of Christ, get a fucking rebound.
Chance for an easy one.
I love that. It's like Black Swan, but not weird.
Misses the second. Not a very good night at the line.
Nope.
Dick.
We're gonna go for the win.
No excuse.
Oh, god damn you.
Where I'm from, that's called back-to-back wins, Mr. Vitale.
Damn it.
Hey, winning consecutive games like this.
That's what I fucking get. Did they just have one dude that did 41 points?
Players of the game.
41 points.
Get that W, baby.
Holy duck fuck. Boy, am I rusty at this game. Ah, the Drake game. Let's see, I think I'm 1-1 for Iowa team, so hopefully I can be 2-1. Drake is a good team in this game, though. I mean, they went to shit right after this, but they're a good team in this game. Ah, we won! Ha! Yay! Alright, now we got a good chance now that we're doing a bunch of, conference games. Oh, damn. Yeah. Nope. We may let this lead go. Yep, let's see about joining this game. See if I can't change that. Who the fuck is Big R, by the way? Just, I'm imagining he's a Dragon Gate dude, because you guys are talking about Mad Blanky, so. I'm assuming there's a Dragon Gate event on right now. See if I can get the timing down on this. Nope. I think that was gonna go in. this daytime kids anime interesting.
Thank you for joining us tonight with Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews. I'm Brad Nessler.
There's no way anyone in their right mind who's going to fucking Illinois State would make that shit.
The point guard will set things up and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior. And they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
Oh.
Great pressure, great double team, really explosive.
Apologies for that. I'm guessing that's my Immortals game telling me that my team is ready to
Up and inside.
There it is. Come on. Nobody crashes the glass. Nobody crashes the glass. I wish there was a way to, like, change that. I feel like there should be a way to change that. To tell him to crash the glass. Oh my god.
That is a key play at this point in the game, Dick.
Right, Brad. A very heads-up play to get the ball back when they desperately need a back.
Oh, god damn it.
Poor decision.
Will you fucking make a shot?
Yeah, I'm not sure what he was thinking there.
Fucking foul him! Holy shit! Unresponsive fucking game.
So they'll inbound on the near sideline. And they continue to foul to stop the clock. They'll throw it in from the side. Foul, and that stops the clock again.
I hate this, because, like, we're far enough in the game, we clearly should be... Like, they should clearly be in the bonus at this point.
And they continue to foul to stop the clock.
We're still not there in the bonus.
Foul, and that stops the clock again. And we're going to look at the numbers so far this season, Dick.
It's not always about numbers, Brad. It's good to fill the stat sheet, but does he do the little
thing? We're going to lose.
Second shot is good.
Oh, fucking course. Ugh, that's irritating.
Time out on the court, so let's go courtside. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, this is probably a wise timeout here. As you guys know, it gives the coaching staff a chance to discuss strategy.
Boy, howdy. Can they make just...
make decisions. Let's see what unfolds here, guys.
Well, that's why it didn't fucking load, because you put a fucking huge goddamn picture in this.
Have a clear understanding of what the objectives were for the upcoming possessions. Timeouts are a great way to get your team back on track in a way to really work in the tempo of the game. Great coaches have a knack for calling timeouts at the right times.
If I could, I'd totally just broadcast myself wrecking shit in Immortals. That might be what you hear. I'll turn this down. That's while shit's loading, that's what I'll be doing, is I'll just be playing a few games of this. I can usually do this fast enough now that I can complete a game in under a minute, just because of how, like, highly leveled I've gotten some of my people. I want to be super ready for when that thing eventually, for when the online multiplayer eventually goes live. Man, someone needs to start pulling away a little bit. Wrong person to pull away. All right, we'll let that load. I'll wreck some people with gold Daniel Bryan. While this does its thing. Hey, CBS Sports! Seems really weird for CBS to do our game. Hang on one second. Let me pause this. All right, I got through one. I couldn't get through the other. All right.
Thanks for joining CBS Sports coverage.
Hello?
NCAA basketball.
3 points. Damn it. Are you fucking kidding me with some of this shit?
Both teams are looking to get something going here.
I honestly think that they just... There's something with the computer in this game. This. Okay, wide open. I mean, but that's the thing, is I can get a guy to put a hand in somebody's face, and it won't mean shit. That's really the main problem I have here.
On the left side. First personal foul. Obviously too aggressive here defensively.
You really got to know your limitations, Gus.
Two shots. Sinks it.
Oh, yeah. We're not in Northern Iowa, so they don't go, whoo. You know what?
He got it up and in.
I still have yet to. Is that supposed to be a thing where we're supposed to have waifus? Where we're supposed to have. Supposed to have that one girl that we love over all of them in anime? Is that how I'm getting it right with waifus? I'm not experienced enough in anime that that's. Like. Can you have one each show, or do you just have one in general? Like, is that how it works?
In the post. Shots up. Can't put it down.
Because I technically, I have my favorites for each show. It would just be damn difficult for me to pick one in general.
He fires from long range.
Your wife who chooses you.
Now in transition.
Oh, he totally got a hand on that shit. Those are called best girls. Okay. Because I know the best girls.
Out on the way. Jump shot. He gets the shot to fall.
Okay, so your favorite one on each show are best girls.
He shoots from the corner. Misses from the outside.
Once again, I'm not experienced enough in anime to kind of know all the technical, you know, all the wording for that shit. Oh, really? Did we actually, like, get the steal on that, and then he stepped out? God damn it.
Fires. No. Out on the right wing.
There we go.
This guy is a complete player in the post.
The big fella, he can beat you face
up. Yeah, just if you can give me an explanation as to what it is, feel free to let me know. Like the real deep. Oh boy, like the fucking lonely dudes that worship someone. Is that who a waifu is? Like, the ones that you just basically worship as if they were a real woman. There it is. All right, we still got the tie.
With the big shot. It's
Wow. Guy lives alone, but he has a maid, older and younger sister, and a wife.
The Salukis get possession, and away we go. Call for the foul.
I about shit my pants. I thought he swished it. I'd have fucking thrown my controller across the room.
Sit down and enjoy the moment. We all know how fast things can change.
You know, David, I'm actually a little surprised you did, like, you haven't found a way to make your own Becky Lynch body pillow.
On the left side. He can't get the hoop to fall. Way to stick it.
Definitely known for his power. Gotcha. So waifu is someone you probably don't want to have unless you're really lonely. Or really into anime.
Can't get it to go. The shot won't fall. Ashley handles the pass.
There we go. Because it's weird unless it's Luke Walton.
Put the ball to the floor with conviction and drove it home. They worked the perimeter.
Jesus, what the fuck kind of screen was that? Sorry, it's... Shit, is there a way I could see that replay? See that ridiculous screen that just happened right there? Look at this. Alright, I think it was on him. I want to see this. So he fucking goes in, and that's his screen. That's his screen, is without moving, he literally just moved me out of the way and then fucking screamed. What the fuck? For some people it's less of a joke. Yeah, like, I understand that people take this shit seriously. I mean, I do know of the fucking the Aremo shit where you could, like, fake marry Kirino or, like, Kironiko.
He shoots from the corner.
Boom! I think we got this game in hand, boys. So those otaku people, so, like, the super otaku people would probably be ones who would be featured on, like, a fucking TLC show. In fact, I'm actually surprised that isn't a TLC show that has come out at some point. Like, American Otaku. Like, and then the guy shows his fucking life-size cardboard cutout. A fucking Asana. Complete with love hole. Ugh.
Defensive rebounds are essential to a running
team. I go a little far with the love hole.
This guy has real talent. Great passer and scorer.
You know what? At least it's... Well, actually, you know what? I was going to make a joke about Silica, but Silica's like fucking best girl for me in SAO. I don't know why. She just is. Actually, I think it might be Lizbeth. I think Lizbeth is best girl for me. In SAO.
This layup is definitely worth a second look. Gotta make those guys.
Who the fuck told you about my Asana cutout? That's terrific. Ah! Fucking poorly. Poorly executed game. Poorly programmed game.
I've said it before, Gus. Numbers don't always give you the entire story, but they really help get you started.
Boom.
He was determined to get to the rim.
Is an American Dotaru term for character? Oh boy. Are those for the fucking lolicons that are like... Like, or is the Dotaru thing like maybe perhaps a little bit different? Where it was like, oh, I just wish I could have someone like Silica and then like... Like, just take care of her and like... I still think it would be super creepy, but I think I have a bad feeling that the... Good point. I still find something semi-creepy about it. Because it's like, yeah, I feel bad for these characters, but like someone like Silica, like I think I've mentioned that before in my SAO thing, where it was like, oh, she just wants to hang out with Kirito, and she has a little crush on him, and that's really cute. But, like, it's not one of those things where it was like, oh, I wish I could just give her a hug and tell her everything's okay. I Yes, a daughter. It would be more normal. I just would find it weird about a, like, I guess I got no room saying. I guess I got no room to talk, but still, I'd find it kind of odd. They're just RP. I guess there's just a whole lot of stuff I'm not, like, I'm just not, like, used to yet when it comes to anime. That's just my thing, I guess. Like, I need to get more used to anime. Just culture shock, I guess, yeah. This layup is definitely worth a second. I mean, I think the American version of that is for the fucking wrestling fans that spend $7,000 on a Page event-worn t-shirt, like. So, I guess it can't be any creepier than those dudes. They're set to throw it in from the side. Because, like, even though it's, like, because it's, I guess it's one thing if it's a fake character in an anime, and I guess it's something else when it's an actual person with, like, a life and feelings. Sasha's got over, oh my god. I think someone talked about that, that the there was going to be a Sasha thing, like, auctioned off, and it was going to be just as big as the fucking Paige thing. Maybe slightly less. That's a great way to get some easy points. Way out on the right way. Takes away the pass. Similarly obsessed. Yeah. I guess I'd find it less creepy if it was just a fucking 2D character. Cause, like, you're just, like, okay. Cause, if you imagine this, like, imagine someone with an actual asana cutout and then they're taking a picture of it in their bed. I would find that to be a little less creepy than someone who actually, like, tweets a picture to Paige of him and his fucking Paige cutout laying in bed. Like, because, like, you're not creeping out just, you know, just people who are like, okay, well, you can actually creep out the person that you have the cutout of. Fired. Squared up on the catch. Got his puppies in order. The Panthers knew what they had to do to get back on track. No. Duck Dynasty does not have a fucking college bowl named after him. I refuse to believe that is a thing. Clement Ashley, by the way, is the name of one of these guys. His parents must have hated him. The Duck Commander Bowl? Oh, God. I guarantee you there's some poor soul out there who's got, like, one of the fucking Curino body pillows and has, like, cut a hole into it and installed a fleshlight. I guarantee that's a thing. Someone has installed a fleshlight into one of those fucking body pillows. I guarantee it. Oh, come on. Come on. Oh, there's no coming back from this. I'll just let it go. Oh, no. Start getting on a roll, then they got back into it. Oh, my God. I fear what you would be linking in this chat. Thing from last. Oh, God. Oh, the orgasm wars. God damn it. Jesus. Oh, that thing. I feel dirty just remembering that. By the way, I'm not gonna shit on otakus, because if the fucking figures were cheaper and I didn't have to pay like $60 for a fucking Kuroniko figure, I would definitely buy one. There'd be like several of us. Like, we need like anime pop vinyls. Like, I'll pay like $10 a piece for some fucking pop vinyl type figures. It's just way too much money to be spending on fucking figures, though, of anime. Unfortunately. I don't want to drop anywhere from $50 to $130 on something. Yeah, that's what I'll take. I'll take, like, we need anime pop vinyls. I'm sure someone has custom made some of those. As long as the character's really pious. Yeah, see, that's the thing. Like, then I could get a fucking, like, maybe an SAO one, but I highly doubt I'm going to be able to get... I highly doubt I'd be able to get, like, a fucking Tomoko one from Watamote or... Yeah, Kuroniko, yeah, not to mention Kuroniko is fucking popular as fucking all hell, as I found out through searching through Reddit. Reddit actually had a, what was it on their, their Aw anime board? Like, give up hope on Watamote, yeah. But they actually had, like, a tournament, like an NCAA, like, March Madness-style tournament featuring, like, the best girl. And Ruri... ended up getting second. She ended up in the finals. She beat out Kirino in one of the earlier rounds, too.
Nice to have you along with us tonight.
Which is one of the more interesting ones.
I'm Brad Nessler. We got a good one going.
Oh, God damn it. Why would he step out there? Fuck. See, now I gotta do this horse shit. I either gotta foul or get a fucking steal off these dudes. Yeah, we'll just do that. Fuck it. Just go. Just let them get their 2 points. Get down the court. Pop up a three. Miss the three. Miss the rebound, because why? Why actually crash the boards? Wow, that was the stupidest thing I have ever seen in my life. Oh, he missed that too! Yeah, done. 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 I think that completely exited out of the game, but who gives a shit? I'll redo that shit. Holy crap, am I done. Dragon Gate sold out. Nice. And we started like shit. There we go, starting to get it together a little bit. Nope, we can't hit dick. Alright. This wasn't even going to be fucking close this time. Holy shit. Oh, and now we get to play Creighton. Probably going to go about as well as the Bradley game. 30-ish. Yeah, that wouldn't be too bad. That's still $30. Like I know they're considered collectibles, but holy shit. Do I have a chance? I probably don't have a chance. I'll just take my loss and leave with my tail between my legs. Tyler could use a win right here. Who the fuck am I facing? The Sycamores. Who the fuck is it? Indiana State. Yeah, if we don't beat Indiana State, how fucking sad is that gonna be? Come on. Come on, guys. Don't you dare do this shit to me. Fucking start putting down some goddamn baskets. There you go. Jesus. Signing week. I already did all that. My people are signed. Oh, Timefly left. I just noticed that as well. Probably got sick of my bitching. I wouldn't doubt it. This game fucking sucks. Why did I do this? Oh my god. Hang on. Hey, we did it again. Playing Counter-Strike. I tried to get into Counter-Strike. I just couldn't do it. It amazes me the amount of people who get into fucking streams of that shit. Like, Counter-Strike and, like, League of Legends and Dota. It's like, holy shit. I also saw the Call of Duty World Championships because my roommate wanted to see what it looked like. Holy shit. Is that... No, Tyler's right. He probably hates them. You fucking asshole. Oh shit, I forgot I was in the middle of a fight. Like, a couple of games ago. Oops, that was only 133. That's alright. You cannot fucking handle a level 14 gold Daniel Bryan. That is... I got super lucky too, because that was the one I wanted. When I ended up getting the fucking gold Daniel Bryan in like a random gold pack that I had enough money for, I was so stoked because that was the one guy I wanted. I managed to pull him and I just fucking freaking out. Oh, level 16 now. Okay. Sweet. What show is that? 'Cause, wow. Okay. Now I can see people spending a little bit of money on statues. Like, if you're gonna spend some money on a statue, you know, that's... Okay. I can justify spending a little bit of money on that.
And our trifecta for the night.
And I am aware that you can get some pervy versions of some of your some of the characters that you would want to have.
Point game. So Dick's so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up in the...
Oh my god. There. Boom. With a push guy on the interior, and they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior. Oh, get it.
Good job defensively. They just won't get many openings.
There it is. For the win. Oh my god. He got it! After a fucking bumblefuck of a shot. What the fuck? Don't care, still win.
Northern Iowa takes the victory, but it was close.
They expected to be the victor. They just didn't expect it to be this close.
Brad Nessler saying so long from...
I saw some that were interesting. Some figures that had like a little stand in the back and it holds in nice and tightly so you can actually give them different poses. I think it was a fucking Lucky Star one. Like, there were some Lucky Star ones that actually had like interchangeable eyes and mouths so you can give them like different facial expressions. I remember that because I was interested in getting a Tsukasa one. There we go. Just wanted to feel like I really accomplished something there. Let me quick finish this round that I was in the middle of. Oh, wait, no. I already finished the round. I'm on Lunar Guardian Brie Bella. Funny thing to note. Funny thing to note about the Brie Bella and Nikki Bella in the game is there is definitely a difference even in the drawings of their boob sizes. Like, They didn't forget that little nugget of information. 548, I can do that. Might have been this one. Another ESPN one. They pick the weirdest games to have, like, the CBS Sports thing on. Let me see if I can't beat this Brie Bella real quick. Just wreck her fucking face with Daniel. Having Daniel Bryan wreck her face would be fucking amazing, too. Oh, this is like a boss Brie Bella, too. Whoops. Let's pause that.
The Panthers,
there it is.
Some strides and a really
bam.
I'm sure as a coach, Dick, you always like it when your team's playing great basketball.
Hey, they've been playing well these past few weeks.
Why are we triple teaming, guys?
Can't really ask for it.
With all sorts of time.
Oh my god. My guys are not good at here. Well, yeah, crash board.
Foul, but that might have been one right there, Dick.
Hey, Mr. Nessler, I like that type of play. He's saying to the defense, no easy baskets for you. We're going to force you to make shots.
Chance to get an easy one here. Foul shot, no good. No doubt about it.
Never ever do you want to see anything related to porn. I don't know if you're talking about something completely different now, but never ever do you want to see anything related to porn and being like, oh, hey, I know that dude.
Tries for two.
Yeah, I was going to say, there's no way being double teamed would allow you that sort of... Oh, God.
For the deuce.
Damn it.
Defense breaks down again. Nobody rotates over from the help side.
Daniel receives the ball.
There it is. All right.
Now that's what I call showtime.
You better believe it, baby.
Oh, boy. What question do you have for me, sir? Boom! There it is. Get down the court and slam it home. Wait, what? The gay one worked better than the female one. I'm confused. So is the gay one the trench coat dude? We had a jump ball there. But that's cool.
Look how speed. I tell you, man, there's nothing like having athleticism and quickness.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to
17
feet apart.
The masturbators. I'm confused as to what we're discussing at this point. If you were to get a toy like that and the gay one worked better than a female one, would you get the gay toy or the female one? Oh. Why is this something that we're discussing? Why would there be a gay one? Why would I have to get a gay... Like, how would you know that something is inherently gay, by the way? Just... Like, how would you... Like, okay, because I'm guessing you're talking... Like... I'm just sitting here thinking, how would you know for certain that, like, a certain masturbatorial aid is gay? I'm just wondering that. Like, is it just an asshole and it's hairy? Or, like... Like, is it the mouth, but it has a mustache? Because of the box art. Like, I don't have to look at the box art. Like,
about 3 minutes remaining for two off the glass.
Not to mention, I'm not one of those dudes who just lets people see, like, the shit that I fucking jerk off with or jerk off to. So, you know, I guess I probably work for the one that works better, because assuming no one's going to see it. It's like, how would you know something is inherently gay unless they specifically made it look gay? Oh, wow, that's totally theirs. Well, like I said, like, the only way you would know that it's a gay toy is if there was some male feature that most women don't have that was on the toy. And I don't think that, like, no person, I don't think any company would make something like that, as far as I know, just because they're trying to appeal to a broader fan base. He makes that, I'd be fucking pissed if he made that stupid shit.
He shoots from the deep corner. Dick, he's just taking too many bad shots.
And I don't think he's done yet, Brad.
Come on.
They've got him trapped here, Dick.
Look at that trap, Brad.
Wow. Yeah, I'd go with the best two just because it's like, who's going to fucking see it? Like, that'd be kind of fucking weird, I guess, if you're, like, showing off your fucking fleshlight or whatever to people. And it's like, look, he's even got Freddie Mercury's mustache. It's like, what the fuck?
Let's take another look at this dunk.
Hey, up and away, Mr. Nestler. That's how you go strong to the basket.
With a jumper.
Oh my god. He's not making dick out there today.
The Shockers are on the run. Bad decision there by the senior. He tries the three.
Finally! Something drops.
1 minute left on the game clock.
I knew this was going to be a dandy, baby.
The lead.
Come on!
The three. A great trap initiated by the defense. Too physical. And we're going to look at the numbers so far.
What kind of forums are you going to, by the way? I'd love to. I don't know if I'd love to know, but I'm perplexed to know, like, what forums you're going to that links that sort of video and then reviews shit like that. Like, I'm a little afraid of the things that you're into. Like, that's cool and all. You do whatever you want, but Jesus.
Nearly every single shot has been a challenge so far, Dick.
Come on. Come on. Fucking either swipe the ball or get the fucking foul. How the fuck do you make? How the fuck do you miss that or make it?
Dumps it in. Goes up for two with the layup.
This game blows sometimes. It's one of those things where it was like, I remember this being a halfway decent game, and then I'm like, oh yeah, it's an EA basketball game, so it's kind of mediocre. Northern Iowa. What's that? 11 and 8 maybe? Soon to be 11 and 9? Because he won't, at least, if he's gonna fucking swipe the ball, draw a foul or get the steal. I don't care what, just something. Oh, and then he can do bullshit. Bullshit, anyone from Wichita State can do that hokey horse shit. Not in this fucking game, though. We're talking 2009 here. Like, we're talking a 2009 where Drake is a top 25 team. And Drake in real life is like 3-14 right now. Like, and this is also a game where Iowa State's like somewhere in the 150s in their rankings. Oh god, 4chan. Sorry, I just got kind of a douche chill. But that all makes sense. It all makes sense now. 14-11. So I'm not doing fantastic. It's all right. You're what? You're hot? I thought you said you're high. Oh, you did say you are high. Well, then why are you fucking sitting in here? Yeah. Why don't you fucking go to bed? It's almost 5 in the fucking morning.
What?
Yes! Go to fucking bed. Go! Because you're gonna end up passing out in my bed, is what's gonna happen.
No, I'm not even
tired. You're gonna fucking do some shit.
I'm really fucked up. On all beliefs.
Really? Couldn't possibly tell. So why don't you go be fucked up?
Ass whipping the fuck out of Drake right now. I thought they were a top 25 team.
Yeah, strange things happen. Hell, you and I beat Kansas.
You just put an ass whooping on them. You just.
That's not Jim Ross. That's Oklahoma.
Who are you playing next? Creighton.
Creighton.
Is this before they were good too?
I think so, cause. This is maybe this is I think this is right before McDermott showed up.
Dude, they weren't even good. I don't think they're good anymore.
Even with McDermott, they weren't good.
No, they were top 25 team.
Oh yeah, they were.
But I don't think they're a top 25 team anymore.
Yeah. Either way, it looks like unless they start going on a roll here, we might actually have a win here. Yeah, we should have a win.
Oh my god, dude, you're not ass-whipping.
Oh shit. Okay, good. We ended up getting that, pulling that out at the last minute.
Wow. Maybe I'm good luck.
Or we're also playing kind of shitty, well, not really shitty teams, but.
You're playing teams to your guys' level. Why didn't you choose Iowa State?
What figure is that, by the way? I want to do something different because I chose Iowa State for my football thing, and I don't like this is the one chance I get to maybe use either Drake or UNI, and Drake was already a good team in this game, so I picked UNI because like they didn't get really good until like the year after when they beat Kansas.
When did
they beat? That's a Kuronico?
When did UNI beat Kansas?
I don't know why that just doesn't quite look like Kuronico. I mean, it's the hairstyle, but, like, I don't know. That's pretty sweet, though.
Sorry. I don't remember you and I being Kansas.
You don't remember that fucking NCAA tournament? You don't remember that? When they beat them, like, 72-71, they led the entire game? You don't remember that shit? When everyone went fucking nuts? Kansas was the number one team. They were, like, favored to win the whole thing, and then you and I beat them in the second round? You don't remember that shit? No? You don't remember? It was just like 2-3 years ago, I want to say.
No,
can't believe. Yeah, they were a number one seed, and like you and I was like number 10 or something. They had won in the first round, and then. Like I said, Kansas, as the number one seed, was number one in the nation as well. They were like a shoe-in for the championship, and they lost to Northern Iowa.
Huh.
It was like that one dude with the really long name that scored like the winning three-pointer. Or maybe that was the year before, because they did that. I think they did something very similar the year before as well. 2010? Okay. He's saying it was probably 2010. 69-67. There was, okay, I kind of want to check that real quick, because I think they did something very similar 2 years in a row. Because there was the time they beat Kansas, and then there was the time they did something else.
Dude, I can't feel something in my body.
Dun, 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 dun. Oh, good lord. Yes, I heard you. I'd like to know what show that is, by the way. Yep, 2010, Men's Division I Basketball Tournament. Midwest Regional? Yeah, Kansas beat Lehigh 90-74, Northern Iowa beat UNLV 69-66, and then Northern Iowa beat Kansas 69-67. They were the number 9 seed. And then they lost to Michigan State that next in the Sweet 16.
Who won the championship that year?
Was that the Sweet 16? Let's see. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14. Yeah, that was they made it to the Sweet 16 that year. I'm trying to see. Who won? Duke won that year. They beat Butler. I want to say they did something very similar. It was either the year before or the year after. Let me see here. I'm sorry, I'm not actually playing anything right this second, but I'm almost positive Northern Iowa did something very similar either the next year or the year before. Oh, fucking, okay. Oh, that's the Dark Magician girl. Got it. I forgot that the Dark Magician had a female version of it. Oh, that silica one is adorable. Oh, no Iowa team made it in 2011, so it must have been 2009. And Northern Iowa was the only team to make it in 2010. Someone made it in 2009. Let me check. Northern Iowa made it number 12 in the West Regional. West Regional. Northern Iowa. Nope, they lost to Purdue. Maybe it's 2012. I know they did it again recently. There was the Kansas thing, and then I think there was something else that happened. Iowa State. Okay. So, yeah, it was just that one year. But still, that was the year that Northern Iowa beat Kansas, like, had the upset of the freaking decade. I still have a single deck, by the way, of, they're talking about it in the chat. I've never gotten into Yu-Gi-Oh cards, but I still have a single deck left of Magic cards. A solo black deck. And if I could get a deck of Magic cards that I built in the game, of the deck that I built in the game. February? Yeah, I'm already done with the season. Let's see.
What was your record?
19-11.
That's not terrible.
No, not bad. Didn't do the best in my conference. Looks like Bradley, and then Creighton, then Wichita State, then me.
Wait, I thought Drake was in the conference.
Yeah, Drake's in the... Okay, this must have been when Drake started their downfall. Because in the game, they had a really good year the previous year, where they were like 25-3. So this must have been the year that they started their downfall. Conference standings, play of the year, top 25. I don't think we're top 25.
They didn't do anything in the tourney.
Who?
Drake.
What do you mean, in the tourney?
The year that they went.
I don't remember. I don't think so. Oh, that year where they were, like, practically undefeated?
Yeah.
I don't remember. Wait, you can remember when Drake was practically undefeated, but you can't remember when you and I upset the number one team in the nation?
I don't remember when Drake was practically undefeated. You were just telling me about it. Fucking retard.
Oh.
Did they do good in the tournament?
I don't think so. I think they got bounced out in either the first or
what
second
seed
round.
Were they?
I don't remember. I don't think they were a very high seed, though, because they didn't. I don't think they played a lot of tough teams. I want to say there's something that shows. There used to be something that showed. Oh, yeah, bracketology. That's what it was. Auto bids, let's see. Best of the rest. We're probably not anywhere on there. I bet you we're a bubble team. Tell me we're at least a bubble team. Nope. I bet you we made maybe NIT. That's probably the best we can hope for is NIT. I saw Alabama on that list. Mama, we made it. come on. Let's not lose out like this. Come on. It's Evansville. We've beaten them a couple times already. Don't do this to me. Come on, guys. Don't do this to me. Fuck. All right. I'll take it from there, because we're only down by 4 and there's 3 minutes left. Come on. We beat them in every, like, sense of the word. We should be able to beat them. I don't think Bama's even known for their basketball, really, at all. I don't know if they're terrible or not, but they're certainly not known for their basketball.
They're known for their football.
Yeah. I didn't know if it was kind of like how Kansas is with basketball, where they're amazing at basketball and semi-terrible at football, where Bama's, like, amazing at football and semi-terrible at basketball.
The Panthers have improved quite a bit over the last few weeks.
Hey, Brad.
Yeah, don't...
practices and a level of commitment from the team. Based on my experiences, teams...
Yeah, don't crash the boards, guys. Come on.
Those two things.
There you go. Force him out of bounds. One guy took a fucking dive, too. They had flopping in this game. That's amazing. There we go. That's what we were looking for. Why are they triple teaming him? Force him out. Force him out. Or do that. That works, too.
They keep forcing them to set up in a half court.
Tell me we got that one.
Let's take a second look at this three.
Man, last name of Ashley, that must be tough. They call me by many names. The Chocolate Hammer. Thunder Rain. But you can call me Tiffany. That's a pretty masculine name. Should be. It's a girl's name. I don't know how to talk to you.
Comes up empty. Gave it up. He puts up the J.
Nice. Now we're ahead.
About 2 minutes remaining.
Wow. Sorry. I'm just amazed someone was talking about Robert Horry in the year 2015.
For the deuce. No.
So how about that young gun, Sharif Abdul-Rahim?
Pushes it up. Tries for two. Was that beautiful or what? 3 points is the difference.
That's right, so somebody better guard the York.
Goes for the deep one.
Got it. All right. We got a chance to win this.
Cross court.
Granted, we don't fuck this up.
With the jumper.
Bam.
It's a 5-point ball game.
That's not a lot of points to be down with this much
nice.
Time, Brad.
Trying to think of more teams. More like lesser-known guys from around then.
Well, at this point in the game, it's about being on the same page. Each player should know
about fucking AC Green, guys.
Offensively, you must know who the number one option is, while defensively, the type of defense you're going to play or whether to foul.
Ah, damn.
Of the essence, Brad.
Well, nobody said it was going to be easy, did they, Dick? Coaching, that is.
I sure hope not. A lot of sleepless nights coaching a basketball team. The expectation to win consistently, not win occasionally, but to win consistently. Winning consistently is one that stresses out a lot of coaches.
No, I do not.
That goes out of bounds, and we'll stay at this end. Ball's coming from the sideline.
I feel like I killed the chat by trying to have fun. There you go. Back up into the line.
Carelessness with the ball is never a good thing.
I don't know. By making jokes about Sharif Abdul-Rahim.
Lobs it.
Damn it.
We're going the other way.
I actually saw there was a website where people actually, like, have, like you can actually, like, scan in or at least enter in the exact figure that you have, and the website will, like, keep the collection of it. And then there's people who just showcase their collections on there, but not like actual picture, like they have actual pictures and shit, but like the figures all have their own deals on them, and like you can actually keep track of like each individual one. It's really weird. Man, I feel like I'm starting to watch the wrong types of anime when you guys post figures.
He launches a three. He's not getting himself in position for the good shot.
Yeah, it's a little bit too much. One on one.
Is that a Luke Walton fucking bobblehead? Oh, that is Asuna. I knew she kind of looked familiar. Didn't they only have like two episodes where she was actually in a school uniform? If that.
And they continue to foul to stop the clock.
But I guess I can't really say much considering Silica and Lisbeth, you know, they have their own figures and they were literally around, at least Silica was, literally around as Silica for like one episode in the entire first series.
Foul, and that stops the clock again. They're set to throw it in from the side.
Based off the novel. That's cool.
He goes for three.
Ah, damn. Is that a bobblehead? Is that what that is? By the way, just... Is Luke Walton your waifu?
Top of the key. Continue to foul to stop the clock. The Panthers are now in the bonus.
I can't blame them. Whenever I'm down, I do this stupid shit too, even though I know I'm going to lose.
Sinks it.
Very nice.
Pushes it up. And after the timeout, we're all set to pick things up. He dials long distance.
Oh, damn, he almost made that shit. Like, it literally just so almost just barely bounced off the back of the rim.
Shine their conference foes with another big
holy
victory.
Dicks.
A couple more games and a conference championship could become a reality.
I love the one dude on Evansville that's just pissed off and kicks the air. Oh, they're so upset. It's so funny. That all made it worth it to watch. To watch the other team get so insanely pissed off. I did happen to find some because I'm less of a figures person and more of like a poster slash wall scroll person. Some of the issues that I tend to have with that is, like, as a single guy, I like to try to make people feel comfortable when they come into my room. So I have, like, maybe stuff that's, like, it's kind of, like, neat little homages to different things, but it inevitably looks kind of cool, and I feel like there are certain posters that I found that would be nice, but would be somewhat off-putting if, say, a female walked in. Like, I found a, like, 3.5 by 4 foot poster of fucking Kirino blowing bubbles in a bathing suit. In a bikini. And I was like, that might be a little much. Nah, I think the last thing I need is an anime 16-year-old girl in a bathing suit blowing bubbles just right here along my wall.
Why?
Just throwing that out there is.
We can do it.
Hey, let's pretend this didn't happen. Oh, darn. Is that how that works? Oh, boy. I guess I'm going to have to start this one over again. I want a fucking NCAA bid. I deserve my goddamn bid. Picture the Joker with an evil grin. Well, that's I feel like that's slightly different than fucking some of the anime ones. Oh my god. Ayase in that fucking cosplay outfit. That is amazing. Is it weird that, like, I just immediately knew that's who it was, and that's, like, I remember that shit, too. Wow, am I getting fucking crushed by Bradley. Yeah, don't come in here, Alex. I'm getting fucking annihilated. I'll just let that one roll. Jesus. Yeah, so I lost. Alright. I guess if I'm gonna get something anime-wise, I want it to be slightly more tasteful than Kirino in a bikini. Like, I think there was maybe like a Kironiko one that looked pretty cool. Yeah, it's that kind of shit that I'm always a little worried about. I want to real quick see if I can find... Yeah, this is the exact poster, by the way, of what I was talking about. That was the exact poster that I was talking about. That's like 3.5 by 4 feet. Some of these. I'll put this for the people that... Oh, wait, no, shit. I don't have the PC thing running, so I can't, like, put this on... I can't put this on the YouTube deal. And that's under Home and Kitchen, by the way. Under the Home and Kitchen section. Trying to find... The one that... Oh, yeah, this was another one that I decided against as well. This was another one that... Because they don't have a whole... weirdly enough, they don't have a lot of Kironiko ones, but that one is one that they had, and I was like, ah, no, I don't think that would work out too well. That's 33 inches by 44 inches. Yeah, they got another Kirino Kironiko one, which would be alright. I don't know. Oh, wait. Shit, sorry. I think I might have actually found one that would work as a decent wall scroll. Sorry. I know this is probably incredibly boring for people watching this on YouTube, and I deeply apologize. It's a little expensive, but at least for the shipping, I think that one would actually work out pretty well as a wall scroll. I'm going to keep this open on Amazon, and I'll check it at the end of this. Maybe I'll just let me just end this season, and then I could just cut this off for the YouTube people, and then just
Welcome to the NCAA tournament selection show.
All right, let's see. Are almost in, and you're so that way I can cut it off for the YouTube people and then just go into like a post like, "Ah, check this out. Check this out."
I'm not sure if there are any surprises
Christ.
Here. I don't think so. Remember, 30 teams get automatic bids. The committee only has to select 34 at
large. Let's see. Is there no UNI yet?
This is a really tough bracket.
No UNI.
Let's now turn to the second half of the field of 64.
No, you and I. Oh, we're not going to get a bid, are we? Damn.
Really good teams.
Damn.
There you have it, ladies and gentlemen. This
missing in action. Oh, we weren't even missing in action. Is that how shitty we did against, like, actual teams? We, like, weren't even, like, in consideration. Holy shit. That's sort of sad. Tell me we at least got an NIT bid. I failed the Northern Iowa as a team. This was the year that they upset Kansas in the actual NCAA tournament, and I failed. Get this game on Vita. What the hell is... Oh, what the hell is that? David, stop posting fucking crippled chicks. Wow, I didn't even make NIT. Holy shit. Save that for... That will be saved for YouTube. I didn't even fucking make NIT. Holy shit. I don't even care who fucking won. Here, let's find out who won. Who at least won the tournament? Was it Kansas? Dude, we didn't even make it to NIT. That is so sad. Ugh. All right, Final Four. Kansas, Kentucky, Duke, North Carolina. Kansas beat Duke. My favorite thing you ever said to me, David. Stop posting crippled shit. You received job offers. All right, let's view the offers. San Diego State, Akron, Houston, Florida State, Boise State, a top 25 team. Huh, Rhode Island, Ole Miss, Miami, Texas A&M. You know what? I'm just going to go. I'm going to not deal with... I'm going to build Northern Iowa. I am here for the long haul. Dude, we got a fucking 4-star? How the fuck did that happen? Sign. How the fuck do we get a 4-star, dude? And what's our breakdown looking at? Damn. Crippled chick is my wife with a crippled spine. What the fuck? We've yet to find a sexy posing wheelchair-bound oracle. What the fuck? Shinon! I've only seen like 3 episodes into SAO2, but she is so far best girl of that season. Let's see, a lot of graduations, including our best guy. Immortals once again telling me that my people are ready to play again. I gotta finish season. I gotta do that too. Oh, I could talk him into staying if I want. I need to take my game to another school. Alright, well, he's just flat out leaving. Alright. Sweet. Oh, well, he's only a 62. Who gives a shit? Fuck him. I figured it was an actual character. Like, I knew it was an actual character because there's a figure based off of it. I just said I don't... There's no need to have some of that shit. You're posting the same chick over and over just to be a dick. Okay, is that three straight? Is that three straight shelves of fucking Ruri slash Karaniko shit? Because that's mildly insane. Like, she's best girl on Arimo, but holy shit, no. Like, she's my favorite one on the show, but Jesus God, no. Alright, so let's see what type of caliber people I can get this time. A lot of two stars. Oh, there's a three star. Let's talk to him. Oh, I got one fucking... You know what? I bet you I need a fucking... No, I don't need a power forward. A center. A center would be nice. So bring you guys back. Oh, no. Retro Dragon. That reminds me of Lucky Star. Maybe is that just kind of the formula for shit like that? Let's do... Jesus. Let's see if we can't get a good center. Center or small forward? Preferably a center, I guess. Wow. There's nobody good who wants to join my team. And I don't need another good power forward. Girls, yay. What the fuck? I might just stick with another center. Let me see, who could I use? Or a point guard. Maybe perhaps a center is probably the best idea. See what I can get. I might take a chance on him. Yeah, 254 points to spend on this dude, so... Yeah, he's coming. He's gonna be here. I want to make sure of it. By the way, why is there a 6'8" center? Why is he a center at 6'8"? Just wanted to know. I mean, not saying you're being an asshole, just posting because you're posting crippled girls. I think you're twisting my words around here. I'm just saying you're being an asshole because you're posting the same girl over and over as if it was just like... Like a fucking stupid joke. Strategy, and then... playing time. And offer the scholarship. I might actually, you know what, instead of just offer the scholarship right away, because I've got time, or I've got points for it, I'm going to take a look at this dude, too. Send a package, send a letter of interest, and watch his game. See which one of these two is better. As well as him. I'm going to get the best possible center that I can actually get my hands on. So he went down a little bit. He's also arguably the best one. Let me see. He's not really slow, but he's not fast either. He's probably got 2 years of college ball before going pro. Let's see him. He's not really... Don't be surprised if he declares for the draft. This might be the guy. Let me check. And this dude... Kid worry the scouts of the abilities. Wowed the scouts. He's not really. Don't be surprised if he declares for the draft. Might take a shot at him. We'll do location as well. I want to get something out of him. See if he signs. Sign to you and I. All right. Oracle, not crippled. There you go. I don't need no fucking crippled chicks in this chat. The fuck you think you're doing? Posting them fucking wheelies around here. Is there better than a 66? 65? I got a 63. That dude was supposed to be way better than a 63. So, we'll go ahead and redshirt him. He was a redshirted freshman. What do we not need? Shooting guards. We'll redshirt him as well, so we can have a good shooting guard. Probably next year. Give him a chance. Small forward, center, power forward. Trying to see, where's... Okay. Seem to have enough now. No, don't cut him. And we don't really have... We have one person who can be like a average three-point shooter, so I'll have to change things... two people. But I'll still have to probably change things up a little bit. I love how out of context... Yeah. Unfortunately, because it's not on my computer, like, I can't just throw the picture over to... to show people. I wish I could just do that where it's like, look at this fucking picture. Just look at it. NIT season tip off. No, we won't participate. My team preview. Season U preview. Where are we at? Hey, we're at a B. You know what? That's progress. We got progress. So that's cool. And I'm a B coach. All right. Considered by many to be an underrated coach, he's helping this season. We'll put him and his team among the nation's elite programs. Fucking nice. All right. We're one of the top teams in the conference, too, by the way. Suck it, Bradley. Suck it, Drake. Suck it, Creighton. Let's see some of the other Iowa teams real quick, just because I wanted to see that. Iowa State, B-, suck it. And Iowa's a B+. Okay, that's cool. Team will lose confidence in the coaching staff if they get off to a bad start. Oh, they must gotta have a new coach or something. Alright, let me set this up. And then this will be, and then right after this is where I'll cut it off for YouTube, and then we can just sit and post fucking anime figures. Who are my key people? My power forward, my point guard, and another power forward. All right. And I got 3 scholarships for next year, so that's not bad. I got a pretty decent team, to be honest, so that's pretty cool. I think I already decided my starting 5. That shit's pretty much already taken care of. Wiggins is a senior. Yeah, we'll just... 73-72. Yeah, it kind of goes down kind of sharply, but oh well. Customize the schedule. Alright. So let's remove some of these games. Baylor, Colorado State. Alright, so now let's add some games in. Actually, you know what? How do I add in a... I could have swore I could be able to add in a tournament. I guess I can't. Oh, that's in fucking college hoops. Never mind. Let me just pick somebody. Alabama. Nope. All right. Alabama. We'll play Alabama to start off. There you go. Let me see here. Who would be an all right team? I want someone from a big faction, but they're not fantastic. Like Baylor. We can try to do Gonzaga again. All right, we got Gonzaga. Thank you for that. You're welcome. Let's see. Let's do it. Nope. All right. Worth a shot. Iowa State, how about it? Come on. Come on. All right. There you go. Let's see here. Right there. Let me see. Is there like a... Okay, I kind of already checked the ACC teams. I feel like there's another big... Okay, Big East is kind of one of those... kind of bigger teams. Let me check here. Seton Hall. All right. Let's try to fit in a couple more games here. Big Sky, Big South, Big West. You can try Old Dominion again. All right, Old Dominion wants us. Let's go back this way. Sunbelt. Sunbelt's not usually a big one. South Alabama, featuring the world's worst football team on college, on NCAA football. I'm trying to think who would make a good. Who ended up being like a big, out of nowhere team? Fucking, where was it? Was it in the Sun Belt that had the? I don't even remember the name. Mississippi State, LSU, South Carolina. Maybe we can do South Carolina. All right. And then we'll fit one more. We'll fit right here between Alabama and Gonzaga. Put something maybe a little bit relatively easy. But maybe still like a team. Like... I'm trying to see here. Richmond? Temple. All right. So we got a fair amount of both types of games. Three-star schedule. Oh, boy. All right. I'll see what I can do about maybe one of these games. Because I kind of want to have a better team than that. So let's get rid of Seton Hall. And we'll try to add in. We'll try to go for like a big team here. Like Clemson. There you go. There you fucking go. That's what it was. Florida Gulf Coast. That was the one that I was thinking. And I think they're Sun Belt, and I don't think they were in it. I'll take four stars. that'll give me a good chance. If I do pretty well, then that'll give me a good chance to... Shooting. Nice. Alright. Recruiting Central. We got three scholarships. Oh, Jesus, nearly fell out of my chair again. Looking for some decent prospects here. Who should we be getting? A power forward. And then maybe a good center if we can get it. So there you go. There's another three-star guy. That may be the guy if I can get him. Let's actually take him out. You know what? We could probably use A minus B plus. You know what? We'll get him as a possibility as well. I need a good solid center. Who's a good solid center? He's not great. Come on. A three-star center would be, like, amazing right now. And I'm not getting any of them. Let me go up, see if I missed anything. Nope. All right, so I gotta go hunt for a center. All right, one of those guys looks like he's gonna be coming with me at the very least. So that's cool. Center, who can I get? 2, 1, 1, 1, 1, 2, and then 4 after that. God damn. Alright, let's try him. And then... fuck. And I'll see if we can't get another good guy. Who's another good guy? Another power forward? I don't like that. You don't need any more damn power forwards. There. Yeah, I'm not gonna listen to the fucking people that he has on... Like, okay, Frost, Crawford, Klein, Clements. I'm going to remember that. Because those are the only four I'm taking. Frost, Crawford, Klein, Clements. All right, now let's get rid of all of them but those four. There's Frost. There's Crawford. Ah, so many people. Now that was a three-star guy, actually, that looked like he had some... Or maybe I was just imagining things. Let me see. Okay, Klein's down here, and Clements is down here, too. Ugh. Come on. Klein and Clements. Bates can go, even though, nah, he was a medium. I don't need that. Why do you think we should be going after these guys? Like, they're not gonna join us. Like, no amount of begging is, like, they're getting recruited by people by, like, Oklahoma. Let me, like, get into the NCAA tournament before you start giving me some 4 and 5 star guys. Just trying to keep myself realistic here. Alright, send letter of interest. Watch the game. Sign letter of interest. Watch the game. Sign letter of interest. Watch the game. And with him, I'll send a letter of interest, and then I'll do internet research. Because it's too much to go watch his game. Fuck him. Actually, how much did it cost for some of these other guys? Hope I'm not doing too much here. Alright, 7. That's not bad. 14's not terrible. And 28, Jesus. But that's a guy that I might probably want. So, alright. Sweet, I think I'll save this, and this will be where I cut it off for YouTube. So, thank you to the YouTube people who decided to actually watch this crap and be outside of all these inside jokes on shit that's going on. I apologize for that. I'll try to do a better job to keep everything within the realm of this game, so that way, you know, it's not too confusing or anything like that. Alright. Let me see about where in the Crippled Girls for Life happened in the chat. Alright. Crippled Girls for Life. That's just how I'm going to end it right there. Alright. To the YouTube people, thank you. Crippled Girls for Life.